The Bible actually tells us that there's a war coming that's going to kill 2 billion human beings.
Define marriage.
I believe that marriage is the union between a man and a woman. But I do believe in civil unions.
Hamas has said clearly and publicly that they are not going to continue the truce, and the same day they attacked Israel.
When the confirmation of the covenant occurs, it marks the beginning of the final 7 years to Armageddon.
Today is Friday Open Lines. Give us a call right now, 1-877-END-TIME.
There are two things I don't discuss, politics and religion.
In my house, we don't talk about politics and we don't talk about religion.
I'll talk to you about anything except politics and religion.
I never talk about politics and religion.
Politics determines how we'll live here on Earth. Religion determines how we'll live forever. I'm Irvin Baxter. I think it's time we talk about it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has been some week here at Politics and Religion. We have seen many events between Japan, between Libya, and all of the other developments of the week. It's been a very suspense-filled week, frankly. Of course, the big news coming out of Japan with the Fukushima nuclear power plant, everything going wrong there, belching out the nuclides from the power plant, all kinds of mixed reports, not knowing what to believe for sure, people risking their lives to save their country and save the world. The latest from there is telling us that yes, the threat has been up to a level 5. The maximum is level 6 or 7, I think it is. Level 5 is the same as Three Mile Island. Well, they upped the level just today, and they're letting people know that the radiation is deadly enough to kill you. They are contemplating right now whether they can bring it under control by pouring water and cooling the nuclear rods that are there, or whether they will end up having to bury it in concrete like they did Chernobyl way back in 1986. So the fight is ongoing. The United States of America is very much engaged there. Japan is fighting feverishly. However, it doesn't appear they're making any progress yet. The jury is still out on what is going to happen. One of the things of concern is that the winds are scheduled to shift in Japan this weekend, and the shifting winds will bring the nuclear fallout closer to Tokyo. Tokyo is about 170 miles south of the nuclear problem, and of course Tokyo has 39 million people in its metropolitan area, so you can imagine how horrific it would be if significant fallout actually engulf the city of Tokyo. It would be a disaster beyond comprehension. So that's another thing that we could all pray about. We could ask the Lord to spare the people of Japan, the people of Tokyo, that. In the meantime, radiation did reach the west coast of the United States of America yesterday. However, it was so weak that it was really said to be at least insignificant. As we mentioned yesterday, people flying in from Tokyo, some of them have had radioactivity detected on their suitcases, on their clothes, but nothing large enough to even put them through a decontamination process. So there's a mix of good news and bad news. A quick review of the week, and by the way, this is open line. If you'd like to be on the air with us today, you can ask any question that you want to ask. I don't know whether I can answer them all or not, but we'll certainly try. The number to call is 877-END-TIME. If you like numbers better, the numbers are 877-363-8463. So, 877-END-TIME to be on the air with us. 1-800-END-TIME to reach our operators if you're interested in our tour to Israel or in our 10 DVD series on Bible prophecy. If you'd like to know about either of those things, then call the operator number, 1-800-END-TIME. But on the program today, 877-END-TIME, just a brief recap of some other things we've discussed throughout the week. We talked on Monday about the prophecy of Jesus that there would be wars, rumors of wars, earthquakes in diverse places, different places, and the fact that what we're witnessing right now is a prophetic fulfillment of Matthew chapter number 24. And then on Tuesday, we talked about the prophecy concerning nuclear power in the Bible. The prophecy is 2,500 years old. It's in the book of Zechariah chapter 14, verse number 12. And here's the way it describes the result of a nuclear bomb. Now, this particular description is of how nuclear weapons will be used at the Battle of Armageddon in the nation of Israel. It says there that this is the plague wherewith I will smite all those that come against Jerusalem. Their eyes will be consumed in their sockets, their tongues will be consumed in their mouths, their flesh will fall off the bone. It's an incredible foreknowledge of the effect of nuclear radiation on the human body. If you'll read an account of the fallout from Hiroshima and Nagasaki in World War II, it's just like you're reading from Zechariah chapter number 14, verse number 12. So very, very interesting when we look at all these things. And then on Wednesday, we continue to talk about the nuclear meltdown in Japan, but also Israel intercepted an Iranian shipment of weapons on its way to Hamas. And I guess the thing that compounded this was that two ships that came through the Suez Canal, the first warships belonging to Iran that have come through the Suez Canal since the Iranian Revolution in 1979, and there was a lot of attention given to this. Well, those two ships apparently were loaded with arms designed to be smuggled to Hamas because they ported in Syria. They unloaded their cargo, then they put it on another ship, and it was on its way to deliver the goods to Hamas indirectly, and Israeli Navy stopped that ship, confiscated the weapons. So this is bringing Iran and Israel closer and closer into direct confrontation. So another very interesting thing throughout this particular week. And then yesterday, I thought we had a really critical program. By the way, let me pause once again to give you the number. It is open line here at Politics and Religion. You're welcome to call in any moment, 877-END-TIME. We will be taking your calls throughout the program today. But I thought it was really interesting yesterday when I realized a nuclear plume was on its way to the United States of America. I began to wonder, you know, how serious is this? Is this serious enough that a person should go get potassium iodide pills? What are all the implications? And even though all the reports told us that is not necessary, yet, as I thought about it, my mind went ahead to a time when these types of measures will absolutely be necessary. We know there's a war coming that's going to kill one-third of the human race. Nuclear weapons will be used in that war, and I'm talking about a war that will occur before the second coming of Jesus Christ and before the Great Tribulation period. So consequently, I begin to think about that, and just the amount of concern that was around the United States yesterday. The reports came in that there was a run on iodide pills, people going out buying them just to make sure in case they needed them. And my mind went ahead to the time when the Bible teaches that 2.3 billion people will die. The war obviously will be nuclear. You don't kill 2.3 billion people without nuclear weapons. And the United States will undoubtedly be involved because the war is going to come from the Euphrates River area. We have 230,000 troops in the Euphrates River basin right now. So we're obviously going to be involved as much as I wish we were not going to be involved. And so perhaps the United States of America itself will come under attack, either by terrorist attack of dirty bombs being detonated in American cities, or possibly an intercontinental ballistic missile attack from the nation of China. We don't know that for sure. The Bible doesn't explicitly tell us where those attacks will come from. It does not explicitly say that the United States of America will be hit. It does say, though, that 2.3 billion people, one out of three on Earth, one out of three of mankind, will be killed. Consequently, I was thinking about all this and what perhaps we will be thinking and doing as that time approaches. So those are some of the highlights of the week. We are going to the phones right now and calling today from Indiana. Hello, Teresa. Welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
Brother Baxter, I have a question about the two witnesses in the book of Revelation.
Okay.
Are these actual people that are going to be out there witnessing, or is this symbolic for, you know, two religious groups, or, you know, something other besides two actual people?
No, it will be two actual people. They are alive on Earth right now. Many people have wondered if it would be Moses and Elijah, because the miracles they do are replications of the miracles of Moses and Elijah. However, I absolutely do not believe it will be Moses and Elijah. They've already died and they've already appeared. Well, actually, Elijah was translated, but they both appeared with Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration. So we have no account of people being reincarnated and coming back to Earth 2,000 years later. Consequently, I absolutely believe it will be two men who will be prophets. The Bible says that they will be killed and lie in the streets for 3.5 days. So these prophets will not be immortal. They will be mortal human beings. And I believe they will come in the power and the spirit of Moses and Elijah. Just like John the Baptist was not literally Elijah, but Jesus said that he fulfilled the Elijah prophecy that Elijah must come before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. So I believe it's going to be the same thing, that these will be two witnesses that are on earth right now. God is preparing them. The Antichrist will have his, Satan will have his two witnesses, the Antichrist and the false prophet. God will have his two witnesses, and that's these two prophets that will preach for 3.5 years, after which they will be killed, and then they will raise from the dead right at the time of the Battle of Armageddon.
But they will be putting plagues and stuff on people also?
The Bible says that they will be able to bring plagues against the Antichrist and against his kingdom. And many of the plagues seem to be the same plagues as are listed under the vials of Revelation chapter number 16. And the Bible says they'll be able to cause it not to rain, and they will be a thorn in the side of the Antichrist. I believe they will be two people who perfectly understand the prophecies. They're going to know who the Antichrist is. They're going to understand all about the mark of the beast, and they will expose the program of the Antichrist to the world, and all who care to believe them will have their eyes open as to what is really going on, and then most of the world will not believe them, and they will follow the Antichrist and the false prophet into their one-world government and their one-world religious system. So it's going to be very much Antichrist and false prophet against the two prophets that God will raise up that are described there in Revelation chapter 11.
Okay. So all of this happens before the Battle of Armageddon.
Yes, it does. You'll find the Great Tribulation, that 3.5-year period that's described several times in the Bible, begins in Revelation chapter 10, about verse number 7, and then immediately you move into chapter 11, and chapter 11 is a description of the final 42 months before Armageddon, and that contains the ministry of the two prophets.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Hey, thank you very much, Teresa.
Every Monday at 9 p.m. Central on the Church Channel and at 10 p.m. Central on Daystar, Irvin Baxter presents End of the Age. End of the Age is a 30-minute program which gives intricate details about how Bible prophecy is not only true, but also how it lines up so perfectly with events going on in the world right now. Don't miss one End of the Age program every Monday at 9 p.m. Central on the Church Channel and at 10 p.m. Central on Daystar. Visit endtime.com for more details or call 1-800-END-TIME.
When you think about Bible prophecy or the end of the world, what comes to mind? war, destruction, famine, disease, 666, mark of the beast, antichrist, false prophet, four horsemen, trumpets, seals, and vials? What about 2012? How does all of this affect you as a teenager in today's world? Those are all good questions, but the thing to remember is that Bible prophecy was not put here for us to be afraid of it, but for us to know what is to come. When I was a kid, I used to pretend that I could see the future and predict